Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 246 of Java for tester series, that is enum. So what is enum? Enum, in simple terms, is a group of constants under a single name. So let's understand this statement. I'm saying that enum in simple terms is a group of constants under a single name. What exactly is a group of constants? Let's focus on this group of constants. In order to understand this group of constants, you have to understand first what is a constant. What is a constant in Java? Once you understand what exactly the constant in Java, you will understand a group of constants easily. So in Java, if you have to represent a constant, you will write something like this: public final int, and count is equal to 5. Here you can see this variable is specified with final non-access modifier. When you mention a particular variable with final non-access modifier, you cannot change the value. Okay, once you assign some value like 5, you cannot in the next steps, you cannot assign a different value to this particular count variable. And also, constants are generally represented in caps. That is like this. To represent something like count, you have to write count completely in caps. This is actually a constant, guys. Okay, you can use this constant anywhere and its value is not going to change. This is all about the constant, guys. Why we use constants in Java? To create some variables whose values are constant. They are not variable, they are constant, guys. There is a difference between variable and constant, right? In variable, for a variable, the value keeps on changing. You can keep on assigning a new value to the variable. That's why we call it as variable. It values changes, so variable. Whereas constant, the value is constant. It will be there only. The value will not be changing. That's why we call it as constant. Now, let me show you practically how a constant looks like in Java. Okay, so let's say this is a Java project. If you create some class here, say demo class, with some main method. Inside this main method, you don't need a main method actually. Okay, you don't need a main method. I was habituated to create the main methods inside the classes, so I say it like that. Okay, let's say there is a class. Okay, inside the class, you can create a constant. Public final int count is equal to 5. Okay, this is a constant, guys. This count is a constant. You cannot change the value. Just try to change the constant. So for that, let's create a main method and try this. Public static void main string of args like this. Now let's try to change the value of this constant. If I say count is equal to term 6, immediately I will get a compiler error saying that. Okay, so it's saying first you need to change it to static. Let's change it. Still you are getting the compiler error. The reason for the compiler error is count cannot be assigned. Okay, you have to remove this final non-access modifier from this count. It is saying because this is a constant, this is a final value you can assign to this count, and you cannot change the value anywhere. That's a constant, guys. It's all a constant. Why we use constants? Constants are used in general where if the values are fixed, okay, they are not going to change. Such kind of things are constants, guys. We sometimes need the things like constants in our programs where whose values once assigned should not be changed. Okay, we should be aware of that. These values will not be changed. So we should not allow other areas in the program to change the value of this particular variable or constant, you can say, to change the value of this particular constant. So such is the use of the constants in Java. That's fine. That's so much about the constant anyhow. But guys, here I am saying enum is a group of constants under a single name. Under a single name. I'll explain how you can create a group of constants under a single name using enum. Okay, anyhow, you understood what exactly a constant is, so don't get so much involved in such a way that this constant is same as enum. Okay, they are different guys. Enum and constant both are different. Okay, I just explained to make you understand what exactly a constant is, but enum is a different thing. Okay, enum is a different thing which I am going to explain soon. Let's delete this and then let's continue with the remaining portion of the session. So enum is a group of constants under a single name, and it is also known as enumerated data types. Okay, sometimes people also call this enum as enumerated data type. Okay, we also call enum as enumerated data type in Java. Enumerated data type. Fine. So guys, now let's start looking to enum in a practical way. Okay, how to use enum in Java? How enum is a group of constants under a single name? Let's find it out. So enum, in order to create enum, we have to use our Eclipse IDE. We should have a project. Okay, you already know how to create a class or interface, right? How do you create a class, guys? You have to say right click on src or something and say new, then class. A class will be created. How to create an interface? Right click, select new and interface. Similarly, in order to create an enum, you have to say do the same thing, that is right click, select new and select enum. You have to select enum. When you select enum, new enum type kind of dialog will come. Similar to creating a class and interface, you have to create enum, guys. So you have to give the name here. Now let's give some name as color. Okay, enum name I am giving as color, and click on finish. Public enum, enum name. Okay, public enum, enum name. An enum got created, right? An enum got created. So we have to create enum like this. Similar to class, we have to create an enum. So how this enum is a group of constants, we need to understand the next thing. First you have to create an enum like this. And how this enum is going to be a group of constants. So inside this block of enum, you have to specify the constants. That is, what are the different colors we have, guys? I mentioned this enum as color. So let's take some example of color constants, like green, red, blue, white, purple, yellow, orange, black. Okay, black. Any other colors left? There are many colors, right? There are many colors actually. Okay, this will be enough for now. Green, red, blue, white, purple, yellow, orange, black. Okay, these are all constants, guys. You see, you have separated these constants with comma here, and at the end you just provided some semicolon. This is optional for a while. Okay, this is optional, but better to keep, guys. Better to keep. So green, red, blue, this is white, purple, yellow, orange, black. These are all constants. So a group of constants should be represented inside an enum like this. Enum is a group of constants. Enum is a group of constants under a single name. What is the name under which this group of constants are there? Color. That's why I said enum in simple terms is a group of constants under single name. Here, these are the group of constants under single name known as color. Okay, group of constants under single name known as color. So this is how enum looks like. This is how the enum looks like. Now, so by default, every constant is public static final object of its group name. Okay, so here by default each and every constant here is of public static final object type of this group name, that is color. Okay, so what do I mean? if I have to represent, okay, internally what's happening here is, let's take some other let's say some other package or something, so that I want to represent the same thing. Maybe I'll name this as representation package. How I would like to show you how this enum thing is represented internally, okay? So not explicitly, internally at the back side of this code, how the internal structure will be there for the enum. Let me show you here. So let's create a class, guys, okay? So enum will be represented as a class at the back side like this. New class, let's create a class, non same class name, that is color. Excuse me. So color, and click on finish. Just drag it somewhere so that you can see both this enum and class together. Okay, so here enum name is color, so similarly class name will be color. Okay, so here a group of constants are there. So how this group of constants will be represented internally by Java? Okay, they will be represented like this: public, static, final. Public, static, final, color, green is equal to new color, like this. Okay, one constant internally Java is representing this enum like this, guys, internally, not explicitly. You can write this explicitly, but this thing is internally implemented by Java. Okay, when you write public enum color of all this group of constants, internally Java is internally representing this structure as like this. Okay, for each and every constant this kind of step will be there: public, static, final, color, red is equal to new red. This is what is happening, new color, sorry. Okay, this is what is happening internally. So here green is holding the object of color, red is holding the object of color, and green is a constant, red is a constant. That's why I'm saying every constant of enum, okay, so let me write down here, every constant of enum is public, static, final, object of its group name. Okay, every constant of enum is a public, static, final, object of group name. Is it object of group name? Yes, we are creating objects. New color means object of group only, right? The group name here is color, so we are creating objects for the color. So, and this one is holding the object of the group name, that is color, and this is of type public, static, final. This object cannot be changed. Once you assign this object to this green, this object is constant object. Okay, so this one is constant, that means you cannot assign another object because this is a final type, and is also static type. Okay, is also static, that means you can access this green with the help of color, color dot green, you can say from other class. If you say color dot green, it will be accessible because it's of static type. Final means constant, you cannot change this particular object. Once assigned, you cannot assign new object to this green, and also it's of static type, that means you can access this particular constant with the help of this class, this name, right? Same thing applies here. Internally this enum is represented like this, guys. Okay, let's repeat the same thing for all the constants we have written. How many were there, guys? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 were there. So 4 5 6 7 8, and let's represent all the constants here, that is blue, white, purple, yellow, orange, then we have black, group of constants. Okay, a group of constants under a single name. We can represent a group of constants under a single name like this by creating a class, but we'll not do that. To simplify that, we have to go for enum, where we will say public enum name. Under that, we will represent all the constants. This is actually internally equal to this one only. Okay, there is no difference, guys. This one is equal to internally, this is equal to this one. So instead of writing this many lines of code, we can simply write public enum name with a group of constants. This will be internally represented as like this. Okay, so guys, this is very important. Why I am showing you this internal representation is very important for our future understanding of the enum. Okay, fine. So let me drag it somewhere to the bottom or something so that it will not disturb us. Fine. Now we have to focus on, let's otherwise close it for a while. Okay, let's now discuss on, whenever required we'll open it. So now let's focus more on the enum, guys. Okay, so that is the next steps, that is printing enum constants. Printing enum constants. Let's do some practicals on this enum, how to use the enum and all. So let's start by printing the enum constants. So how to do that? Let's create a new class. I'll name this class as demo, and with the public static void main inside that, let me drag it to the right side so that you can see this public class demo kind of thing. So here we already have a enum as a group of constants under a single name. Now from this another class, I would like to access one of the constant and print it. What will be printed? Let's find it out. Okay, so I have to say system.out.println. I would like to print a constant. How to access this constant, guys? How can I access this constant from a different enum? Okay, this is a class. Outside the class there is an enum, and from that, inside that enum, we have this constant. How to access this enum from this how to access this constant from this enum, from outside the enum? So for that, we already know that each and every constant here is of, each and every constant here is of static and final type. So let's focus on static. Static means, when you say static, if this particular thing is a static, then you can access with its group name, that is enum name, color dot green you can access, right? Outside the enum, you can access it like color dot enum, because this it is internally static type. So I can say I don't have to create any object, right? I have to simply say color dot enum, color dot constant name, that is green, like this. Similarly, other things also. Okay, all the constants we can access and print. So simple thing here is I'll make it like a empty print statement. I'll copy paste 8 lines so that you can see I'll be able to print all the constants inside the enum. 6, 7, 8. Okay, so fine. So color is the enum name dot, I have to say red. Okay, like this, because red is of static internally. Color dot blue. Color dot white. Color dot purple. Color dot yellow. Color dot orange. Color dot black. Color dot black. Like this, guys, we have to access the constants inside the enum. So guys, we are able to access the constants inside the enum using the enum name, because these constants are by default static type. You don't have to specify static here. They are by default static type, so you can access with the enum name. So enum dot constant, like this you can use. And using this print statement, we can print. What can be the result, guys? When I run this program, that is when I run this demo.java, when I print the constant like this, what will be printed? The constant name will be printed. That is here, when you say color dot green, green will be printed. If I say color dot red, red will be printed. Color dot blue will be printed, like that. Okay, these are actually the constants, they are not going to change. Okay, so the constant name will be printed. So right click, run as Java application. You see, the constants names are getting printed: green, red, blue, white, purple, yellow, orange, black, like this. Okay, so we are slowly understanding how to use the constants, guys. Okay, this is the first step for understanding the enum. This is the first step for understanding the enum. So slow by slow we will go with different things where you will understand entire enum. Okay, fine. Let's go to the next one. We are done with printing enum constants. Now let's use this enum with switch case. So here let's clear out all this stuff that is related to printing. Let's use that with a switch case. Switch case, you already know about switch case, right? You can use the switch case with this enum constants also. Okay, with enum also we can use the switch case. How to use that? Let me explain. So first we have to write down something like this. Okay, before actually I start using the switch case, we have to write something. Let's access some constant using this enum. How to access, guys? Let's say I will access color dot orange. Okay, like this, color dot orange. So color dot orange I'm accessing, but so this color dot orange, if I open this again, the older internal representation of this enum. So let's focus on this line. Here orange is an object reference of this color, right? The object of this color enum is getting stored into the orange, something like this. Okay, and it can be assigned to color. That means when I say color dot orange, that is nothing but this orange. We can assign this orange to the color. That means we can simply say C is equal to color, like this. Color C is equal to color dot orange. This is absolutely fine because you are already declaring this orange as color enum type. So you can assign this color dot orange to the color enum type. Okay, color C is equal to, or you can say color is equal to color dot orange. This is possible because of this statement, this particular representation is possible. So this is nothing but orange that you are assigning to the color. That's correct. Okay, so there is no problem. So let's close it again. Whenever needed, we'll open again. So this kind of representation is possible because internally these constants are represented like that. Okay, fine. Now after this, we'll start using the switch case. How to create switch case? Switch, here we need to provide this color. Okay, this color. Now here I will say case. First case will be, if I say color like this, first case should be only this constant cases are allowed now. Okay, that means you can say green colon system dot out dot println. Okay, I will write some statements. Okay, random statements. Green feels like oxygen. Okay, anything. I'll write something just for the sake. I'll say brick. Then I have to write down second case red colon. Okay, then system dot out dot println. Red feels like danger. Then again brick. Another case, blue colon, blue feels like cool, break. Now let me go with something like case orange. System dot, I'm not taking every example here. I'm not taking every constant. It's not compulsory you have to provide all the constants inside the switch case. Okay, let's take only few constants. Orange feels like sunset. Then brick. Another case yellow. Okay, let's take this as last case. System dot out dot println. Yellow feels like banana and break. Then I can provide some default case, default colon, constant, provided constant is not matching. Provided constant is not matching. If I provide something that is not there, I will say provided constant is not matching. That's it. You don't have to provide break because this is at the end. And guys, there is one another thing you need to understand about this switch case, okay, that you are using with this enum constants. You are using the switch case with enum constants, right? I simply said color dot orange, color. You are using the switch case with enum constants, okay? This is how we have to use. If I say case, if I give something like let's say q of x colon, okay, q of x dot com is my website. If I say something like this, okay, you see I'm getting an error. Compiler error is coming. It has to be either black, blue, green, orange, purple, red, white, yellow only, okay? So we are restricting the switch case to the constants. Any of these constants should be there, but not other term or constant. Q of x is not there in this enum, so it's not allowed. So like that, guys, when you use switch case with enum, it will be like this, okay? Only these constants will be allowed to be validated. Other than that, if you try to provide anything outside of these constants, you'll get a compiler error, okay? So color is equal to color dot orange. When you provide color here, if I run this switch case, what should be the result, guys? What should be the result? Constant here is orange, so orange will come here. Orange will be checked with green, no match. Red, no match. Blue, no match. Finally, orange. Orange is matching with orange, so it will print orange feels like sunset, and then it will break and come out of the switch case. So this is how the switch case can be used with enum constants. Okay. So when I run this program, you'll get the output as I mentioned. Orange feels like sunset. Okay. This is how, guys, we have to use switch case with enum. That's another way of using enum. Now third one. Let me explain. Let's clear out all this stuff. Third thing that you have to practically, how to practically use enum, okay? About that, enum extends enum class. So internally, when you create an enum like this, public enum color, it internally extends. You don't have to explicitly provide, okay? When you explicitly provide, you are going to get a compiler error anyhow. It is not allowed to provide in extends keyword here, okay? But internally, at the back side, this is actually is there. That is enum color extends enum class. There is a predefined class known as enum. In Java, there is a predefined class known as enum. Let's search for Java 8 API, go to the Java API documentation and search for enum class. Control F, enum. So enum is a predefined class in Java. Okay. So whose subclass? It's saying the subclass is enum only. Okay. That means this enum is a child of this enum. Internally, this enum is, even though you don't write extends enum here, internally, this enum is a child of which class? Is a child of this enum class. Okay, as you can see here, enum is a subclass of this enum class. It's saying whatever the enum we have written here is internally, even though you don't specify extents of enum, it's internally by default, it is a child class, child type of enum class. What will happen, guys, when there is a child of the enum class, all the methods which belong to this enum class can be used by this enum, right? Can be used by this enum. What are the different methods we have? There are a lot of methods, guys. You don't have to understand all these methods. You have to focus on few methods like ordinal. The method known as ordinal, guys, we have to understand. Okay, I'm going to practically demonstrate how to use ordinal method. Okay, ordinal method. So before that, let me explain other thing. Here you have created something like public enum color. Inside this enum, you have mentioned different colors. So like what were the colors, guys? The colors are green, red, blue, white, purple, then we have yellow, then we have orange, then we have black, like this. So each and every constant here will have some index. Okay, some index value will be there, some index value will be there. That is, this green will be internally represented with an index known as 0. Then it will be index 1, okay, like arrays, guys. Okay, index 2, index 3, index 4, index 5, index 6, and index totally 8 constants are there, starting from index 0 to index 7. Okay, like this. Internally they are like this. So in order to retrieve the index value of this particular constants from this enum, we have to use a method known as this ordinal method. Okay, let me show you how to use that. Okay, how to retrieve that. So if I say system dot out dot println, how to access this constants, guys? How to access this constants? Say if I say color dot, I have to say color dot constant name, because they are static by default. So color dot enum name dot constant name is, let's say, orange dot orange. This is how we can access the constant. At the end of the constant, if you say again dot color dot orange dot, then you will get this ordinal method, okay, which will retrieve the index of this particular constant. This ordinal method belongs to which class, guys? Ordinal methods belongs to this enum class, which is a parent of this enum. Okay, enum class is a parent of this enum type. Fine. So as enum is the child of that enum class, all the methods of the enum class will be part of the enum also. So that's why you can use this ordinal method with the constants of the enum, like this color dot orange dot ordinal we can use. Okay, so if I run this, what will be the output, guys? The output should be 6, guys. Okay, the index value of orange is in the inside the enum is 6, so 6 should be printed. Let's see whether 6 is getting printed or not. Right click, run as Java application. You see 6 got printed. The index value of this constant inside this enum will be printed. That's the purpose of the ordinal, guys. Okay, that's the purpose of the ordinal. What exactly it is? Ordinal. It's ordinal, guys. Okay, not ordinal. Here in my notes, I just wrote wrong. Ordinal. N is missing. Okay, it's ordinal. Fine. We have used ordinal already. ORDINAL. Okay, ORDINAL is the name of this method. Fine. So now let's use another method. Okay, like this, guys, we can use any different methods like this, but we have to only understand this ordinal. Okay, ordinal method. Okay, and I don't have to use other methods, but we have another method known as values, which is not the method of, which doesn't belong to this enum, guys. Okay, this method is not a method of enum class. As you can see here, there is no method like values. Do you see any method like values here? This clone, this compare to, equals, finalize, get something, and hash code, name, ordinal, to string. Value of is there. But whatever the method I am talking about is the values method. Okay. This values method is not a predefined method of the enum class. It's directly provided by Java, guys. Okay. It's direct, values method is directly provided by Java, and it's not, there is not a predefined method of the enum class, but we can use this values method with this enum. Okay, we can use this values method with enum. How to use that? What is the name of the enum, guys? Name of the enum is color. So with this name we have to use, that is, we have to say color dot values, name of the enum, and say values. this this particular method doesn't belong to enum class. Okay, it's directly provided by Java. You can directly use with the enum name color dot values. When you say color dot values, it will return you an array of color. For the mouse, nothing is coming for now. Let's write it again. Color dot values. Okay, you see what is the return type here? Color of array. Okay, color of array is a return type. So I will say color is equal to color dot values for the mouse and say create local variable color array. Okay, enum of array, something like that will happen. If you say color dot values, it will return you enum array. Now how to use this? So here how to use this? Now here what exactly happens is all these constants will be assigned to this particular variable of the enum array. Okay, when I say colors dot values, all the constants in this enum, each and everything with the index 0, 1 and all the stuff will be assigned to the variable of this color array, that is enum array. So how to use it? Let's use some for each loop. For each and every constant is a color type. So color, then something like some x, you can say x, and you have to give this side color. For each loop, I'm using for each loop with this thing to print each and every value that is assigned to this color array. Okay, system dot out dot println, if I say x, what will be the result, guys? So for color x color, all the constants are assigned to this color array, right? That means green, red, blue, white, purple, yellow, orange, black are assigned to this color array. When I say color x is equal to color, so this will check whether there are any colors left. Yes, there are 8 colors left. So it will pick the first color, that is green, and assign to x. And when I print x, what will be printed? This green will be printed. Then again we'll go to this. This will check whether there are any other colors left. Yes, there are 7 more colors. It will pick the first color, that is red, and assign to x, red will be printed. Like that, blue, white, purple, yellow, orange, everything will be printed. Finally, black will also be printed. After everything is done, it will check whether there are any other colors left. No, there are no colors left. Then we'll come out of this for each loop. Okay, let's run this and see whether all these constants are getting printed from this color enum or not. Right click, run as Java application. All the colors from this enum got printed. This is how we have to use values method with the enum to get retrieve all the constants which are there inside the enum. Fine guys, we are doing good. We have printed enum constants. We have used enum with switch case. We have used this ordinal method. Then we have used this values method with enum. Like that, we covered many things. Now let's understand more about enum. So the next thing here is enum can implement interface but not extend other classes. As you already know, let's say I'll take something out of this. Let's say if I create a class, I'll name this class as some demo C. Okay, click on finish. This is for just demonstration, guys. So in Java, so there is a demo C class is there. If I create a few more classes like demo A and demo B, there are multiple classes here. If I make this demo C to extend demo A, extends, inherit demo A by using extends keyword, this is fine, acceptable. But can I say demo A comma demo B? I'll get a compiler error. You cannot extend multiple classes at the same time, right? You cannot extend a single class, cannot extend multiple classes at the same time. So only one class is allowed. If you try to extend multiple classes, you will get a compiler error. That's the thing in Java. Same thing applies to the enum type also. Internally already enum is extending internally. This is happening internally, guys. Extends enum class. You don't have to specify it. This will not be allowed in Java, but internally this is already there. But if I try to extend another class, if I say extends some demo class, I'll get a compiler error. Okay, you can, you should not use extends here, it will say. Okay, that's the reason, guys. Enum cannot extend any other class because internally enum is already extending enum class. So at a time in Java, only one class can be extended. That's the reason enum cannot extend any other class. That's one thing. Second thing is, coming to interfaces, can enum implement any interface? There is no problem. Okay, here if you say, with in our example, so when I said demo ABC, something like this, if I say demo A extends demo B, up to here it is fine. It cannot extend multiple classes like demo B comma demo C. That's fine. But what if I create an interface here? Some I demo something like C, let's say. Click on finish. It is an interface, guys. Where is that? Yeah, here interface has been added. What if I say demo extends A implements I demo C? Is this valid or not? It's valid. Okay, even though the demo is extending demo B, at same time it can implement the interfaces also. That's not a problem. The same applies for the enum type also. Though it is extending internally, though it is extending the enum class, it can implement any interface. That means let's create an interface and let that interface be implemented by this enum. Okay, for example, let's create an interface. Right click, new interface, say I demo interface. Okay, something like this. I just created. Now we have an interface here. I want this interface to be implemented by this enum. Can we implement or not? Implements I demo interface. You see, this is possible. You are not getting any compiler error. You have to understand this kind of concepts, guys. How to use enum? Is enum in inheritance? Can enum extend a class? No, because already enum is extending an enum class internally, so it's not possible. But it can extend any number of interfaces. It can implement any number of interfaces. So this is just to prove, just to show you that enum can implement interfaces but not extend any classes. Fine. Can we create an object for enum? Can we create an object for enum? Try to create, guys. We'll get a compiler error. For enum, for a class, you can create an object, right? For a class, you can create an object. For an interface, you cannot create an object. If you try to create an object for the interface, it's not possible. If you try to create an object for the abstract class, it's not possible. Similarly, you cannot create objects for the enum also. For example, if you say color C is equal to new color, color is a enum type, right? Enum type. If you try to do so, you'll get a compiler error. Cannot instantiate the type enum. Okay, so you cannot create objects for the enum. That's not possible at all. Let's find out more about enum, guys. Let's find out more about enum. So the last thing, that is, enum can include variables, constructors, and methods. Okay, we can use enum. Inside the enum, we can use variables, constructors, and methods. It's possible, guys. For example, let's start with a method. Let's start with a method, guys. Let me create a method inside this enum type. That is, I will create some main method, public static void main. You see, it will be allowed, guys, without any problems. Okay, we can create methods inside the enum. Not only main method, normal methods also I will create. I will show you after some time. So first, let me create some main method. Public static void main, string of arg system.out.println inside enum. Okay, inside main method of enum. Okay, similar to classes, inside the class you can create the main method. Similarly, inside the enum we can create the main method. You run this thing. If you run this enum, what is the enum? Color. Let's run this. Let's see, this will be printed. Right click, run as Java application. Inside main method of enum got printed. That means you can create main method and you can run the enum when there is a main method. Okay, the print statements inside the main method will be printed. similar to the classes. Similar to classes, when you create main method and you create some print statement and you run that class, what will happen? The same thing will happen with the enum also. So methods are allowed in enum. That is one thing. Next thing is constructors are also allowed in enum. You can create constructors also. That means let's create a constructor here. Inside this enum, let's create a constructor. So constructor should have the same name as the class name. Here, since we are creating the constructors inside the enum, the constructor should have the same name as the enum. Color. It's an empty constructor, guys. So inside this constructor, let's create a statement, print statement. Okay, just to see whether when this constructor is invoked, whether this print state, when this constructor is invoked, we'll know by this print statement. Something will be printed if this constructor will be invoked, right? Let's write down some print statement here inside empty, inside constructor. Okay, simply say inside constructor of enum. Inside constructor of enum. How to invoke this constructor? Can we create an object for this constructor? As already explained, we cannot create objects for enum. Okay, how to invoke this constructor? Constructors in classes, if you create a constructor, they will be invoked when you create an object for that class, right? Automatically the constructors will be invoked when you create an object. But here the problem here is you cannot create objects for the enum. If you say something like this, color c is equal to new color, you are going to get a compiler error, because for enum types you cannot create objects. When object is created, this constructor will be invoked. But here I am not able to create object for the enum. So how will these constructors will be invoked? There is a way, guys. That is, whenever you use any of these things, when you use any of these constants, automatically this constructor will be invoked. For example, if I say simple thing, okay, simple thing I'll use, guys. If I say color dot green, I'll simply print out, okay, system dot out dot println, color is the enum type, enum name, dot green. I can call it because green is internally static type, and say dot, this is enough. Okay, when you print green here color dot green here, when you print this green constant of this enum type, okay, automatically this constructor will be invoked. Okay, you don't have to create an object, guys. Simply use one of the constant here, automatically this constructor will be invoked. When you use one of the constant, automatically the constructor will be invoked. And also some other thing will also happen, guys. Though you invoked, which constructor you invoked? Green. You invoked only green. That is, when you invoke only this, you just called or used only one constant, that is green. But this constructor will be called for each and every constant here. This constructor will be called or invoked for each and every constant. That is, you have used only green constant, but this constructor, we generally think that this constructor will be only invoked for this green constant. As you can see here, guys, internal representation of the enum is like this, right? By Java, when you write an enum, the internal representation of enum will be like this. That is, in place of color class will be there. In place of each and every constant, an object will be there. That is, each and every constant is nothing but an object. New color. You see, this color will be invoked. When you say color dot green, only the green related color should be invoked, right? This constructor should be invoked. But here, what will happen here is, in this program, even though you invoked only you have used only green constant, but all the other constants will also be invoking the constructor. That means when you use green constant, all the other constants will also be invoking this constructor. That means how many times this constructor will be called. So how many times this constructor will be called? this constructor will be called this many number of times. For each and every constant, this constructor is going to be called. This constructor is going to be called. This constructor is going to be called. Okay, this constructor, like that. Each and every constant here is an object, is holding an object for the enum type internally. So when you use only single constant like green constant, still all the constructors will be called. From each and every constant, all the constructors will be called. That is, when I run this code, you can see that this particular statement being printed how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Because this constructor is being called by each and every constant. So right click and run this enum. Right click, I have to run this demo class. Okay. So right click demo.java and say run as Java application. You see. So how many times the constructor has been called? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 by each and every constant inside this enum, it is being called. And finally, this color dot green got printed. This green got printed. Okay, the constant got printed. Like this, the constructors work in Java as part of enum. Okay. Now the next thing, that is variables. That is variables. That's fine. Let's use some variables. That is, let's say if I say int, if I say int, give any name, guys. Okay, anything is fine. Let's say if I say some count, I'll take something like count. Okay, there is no relation between the count and color though, but I am taking this as a variable just to show you that inside the enum we can create the variables. We can create the variables inside the enum, guys, like int count. Now, how to assign some value to this count? Is there any way to assign some value to this count? There's no way, guys. There is no way. You cannot directly assign some value to this count. What you can do here is you can create a kind of constructor. Similar to this color constructor, you can create some constructor like this color. We can say int count like this. Parameterized constructor. This is non-parameterized constructor. This is a parameterized constructor which is having the same name as the enum name. Let's set some value to this like this. So this dot count is equal to count. I will say color int count. This dot count is equal to count. Like this, I will say. Like this, we can set the value to this particular variable using the constructor. So here, after setting the thing, I will simply print out inside constructor with value. What is the value that has been set? This dot count is a value. This dot count is a value that is set to this particular variable. Fine. Now what I will do here is how to call this constructor. How to call this constructor, guys? This constructor will be automatically called when you use color dot green. Automatically all the constants here will invoke this constructor. 8 constants are there. 8 times this constructor will be invoked. But how about this constructor? It has some parameter inside that. Parameterized, single parameterized constructor. But how this constructor will be called? Simple, guys. For example, I would like to call this constructor. Then I have to provide some value here. Green of 9. Some white of 5. Orange of 6. Green of 9, white of 5, orange of 6. So what happens here is when you simply use one of the constant inside this main method, color dot green, I mentioned that all the constructors will be called, right? But here green of 9 will not call this one. Instead, green of 9 will call this one. So 9 will be passed to this count. That 9 will be assigned to this dot count, like that. This will be invoked. Instead of this constructor will be invoked by this constant. Whereas what about red? Red, there is no argument available beside the red. So it will invoke normal constructor without any parameter. So inside constructor of enum will be printed. Again, blue also same thing, inside constructor of enum will be printed. But coming to white, this will invoke which constructor? This constructor or this constructor? It will invoke the constructor having a parameter, that is 5 will be assigned to count. So the inside constructor 5 will be printed. Then purple will invoke normal constructor, yellow will invoke normal constructor, orange will invoke the constructor having the parameter 6 will be assigned to this count, and this dot count will be assigned with 6. And when you print here, inside constructor 6 will be printed. Again, finally, black will invoke normal empty constructor, non-parameterized constructor, and inside constructor of enum will be printed. Let's see whether this thing is happening. When you simply use one constant like green, all the constants will be invoking this constructor, either non-parameter constructor or parameterized construct, based on the value that they are passing. Based on this value, these constants are passing. So if I say if I run the demo.java, you can see that first one, green of 9, is invoking this constructor, that is a constructor having a parameter, inside constructor this dot count 9 got printed. Remaining things, inside constructor of enum, inside normal constructor, inside constructor 5, inside constructor of enum, inside constructor 6, this is about orange of 6, inside constructor of enum. So like this, guys, we can invoke parameterized and non-parameterized constructors. Fine. So, and finally, we can retrieve this value. How to do that? We can create a method like public, return type is int, get of public return type int, get count, I will say. Okay, this getter method, this is a getter method which I explained in one of the previous videos. So get count, this I'll say return this dot count, simple, return this dot count. So here I have to say, for each and every constant I want to retrieve this count if it is there. So what I have to do here, I will say this dot, I'll remove this print statements, guys. Okay, I don't want print statements now. I'll simply say this dot count is equal to some. If this particular constant is not having any argument, I'll simply provide some 100. All the remaining things will have their own. 9, 5, 6 will be there. Here, in place of non-parameterized constructor, this dot count will be 100. So for red, this dot count will be 100. For blue, this dot count will be 100. For purple, this dot count will be 100. Yellow, black also, this dot count will be 100. But for green of 9, this dot count will be 9. For white, this dot count will be 5. You are passing 5 and it will be assigned to this dot count, right? Orange, it will be 6. So let's get the count for each and every constant. How to do that? So for doing that, we have to invoke each and every constant, right? So like this. So I have to say color dot values. I have to say color dot values. It will return you an array of these constants. An array of constants will be written. If I say color is equal to an array of enum constants. You see, like this. In this enum array, all the constants will be stored from green to black. Now I'll use some for each loop. For color, C colon color, like this. I'll say system dot out dot println C plus. When I print C, what will be printed? This constant will be printed. That's the first thing. C, I'll print this side, I'll say C dot get count. I'm retrieving this particular count value from this enum using the C dot get count for each and every constant. So what will happen? So first green will be printed using this for each loop. First green will be printed, green C dot get count, that is 9 has to be printed. Using this, we are calling this get count method, guys. Yeah, we are using that constant. We are retrieving the get count, C dot get count. What will be printed? C dot get count means 9 will be printed, green 9. Like that, next iteration, red. For red, what will be printed, guys? For red, there's no argument, so this constructor will be invoked. So 100. So this dot count will be 100. So 100 will be printed. So like this, you can create programs, guys. For each and every constant, some value will be printed here, either 100 or some specified value. So right click, run as Java application. For green 9, red 100, blue 100, white 5, purple 100, yellow 100, orange 6, black 100. So like this, guys, we can use enum. Okay, I just took a lot of examples here because you will get habituated to use enum, guys. Okay, when I take this kind of examples, you will start, you will get habituated with this enum, how to use enum and all. So guys, it's all about enum, guys. Hope you understood enum and how to use it in the Java programs. That's all about the enum. And a lot of practical demonstrations I mentioned as part of the enum. Hope you practice them side by side while I'm explaining this video. Fine. So the next thing that I'm going to explain in this video series is Verax. There's some concept known as Verax, which I'm going to cover in the next video session. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.